neck. Will history repeat in a different setting? Power play on for Team USA. They trail in the game 2-1, 3 minutes to go. Little trickler out in front cannot be read by Smolinski. Instead, it's kept alive, though, by Paul Martin. He and Waite are the point men now on this power play, and it is held to the outside by Gomez. Gets it back again. He's got Waite to his left to pass to. Gives over for Smolinski to save! Made by Kiprasov. Oh, what a shot!
Save that was. Well, that's why this goaltender, Kiprasov, has been one of the best players in National Hockey League for the last 5 months. He's awesome.
There's a paycheck save right there. He earned it all on one save.
Loser of this one is Dunn. Wrist shot. Held in front and then kneeling on it is Teppo Numminen. And then a little extra is reaching in and trying to get to it was Tony Amonte.
Boy, did you see them run to the aid and the protection of Teppo Numminen? I think the puck got caught in his pants. He didn't know where it was, so he just went down in the block position again. Tony Amonte took a poke at him. He is revered by his teammates, Teppo Numminen is.
Toyota's World Cup of Hockey from St. Paul, Minnesota, one of two semifinals. Carried tonight on ESPN2. Tomorrow night, same deal in Toronto, Czech Republic, and Canada. It is a thrill to be here. Fans are standing all around this arena to watch the power play that's got a minute 13 to go. Team USA is down by one. If they lose this game, that will be it for the World Cup tournament for them. Gaining the zone is Madonna. Tried to get it to Kachuk and did. Carried off, though, and taken to the boards and glass by Sammy Salo. Puck turned over to Finland again with 55 left on the kill. Lobbed back in by Jarkko Ruutu. And back to glide by and get it is Brian Leetch. 3/4 of a minute to go on the power play. Round behind, it's Madonna. A little lean from Numminen. Puck cleared out of play, and the signal is that the faceoff will come back outside. Well, will this be the hero of this game? Bill Guerin, who along with Kachuk flanked Madonna in a lineup change and a shift in line combinations, and the U.S. hasn't lost since.
I'll tell you what, right now with a minute and 40 seconds left, there's desperation time. The U.S. has got to send everything that they have, especially with only 30 seconds left here in this power play. They need something now or they're in trouble.
90 to go. 23 on the power play. Scurrying back in is Jason Blake. Blake with a wrist shot, and that deflected, and it goes out of play.
It's just amazing to me how Mika Kiprasov makes everything look so easy. This is not an easy shot to save, but he's just in the right position, and he makes it look like he does this in his sleep every single day. Watch this. Great little play by Blakey to come in, high glove. Yeah, no problem, Mika says.
He slipped up on edge, too, but it still wasn't a problem.
Maybe to make it even harder. A fluttering puck.
His own teammates marvel at his ability to flatline. I'll tell you what, if you ever wanted to bet on an athlete to fool a lie detector test, bet on Mika Kiprasov.
Only you would think of that.
I don't know, buddy. Be careful where you're going with that. But he's that in control of his emotions. Nothing phases him. There seem to be no peaks and no valleys, at least on the outside. And that's why I said, if anybody could fool a lie detector test, it would be him, because his heart rate would never, ever give him away.
He showed that in the playoffs last year with Calgary.
4 feet by 6, yawning open. So the power play on, and it's 6 against a goalie and 4. Quite a goalie. Grubbed back off by Salo, and it will trickle back down, but be picked up by Rapolski with 10 to go in the power play, and down to the last minute and 10. In regulation time, Keith Kachuk hands it ahead, gaining the zone with this is Guerin. Lobbed it back in, Madonna after it. Swung around to the half boards, the battle on there. Waite pitches in. Saku Koivu bounced one that kicked on across. Chased down and cleared back down and wide. And this does not come on a power play. This is an icing, and the faceoff will be back near Kiprasov with 53.1 to go.
This is a big no-no. In the National Hockey League, you never ice the puck with under a minute left with an empty net. And I know guys want to get the goal and everything like that, but don't be selfish. And I didn't know if he thought the penalty was over or not, but make sure you just get the puck out. Don't ice it. Now there's a faceoff in their own zone. This could come back to hurt them.
U.S. has done well on faceoffs out of the 70. They've won 41. Mike Madonna does not prevail on this one, though. Timonen drills it back off. Bouncer went, knifed off Gomez. Sent further, but kept alive by forwards and pound behind now for Gomez. Set up on the front, Couture battling, and at the side of the net, dug out by Gomez again. Works on Bonanno, back on the point, Rafalski, back to Mike Modano again. Over for Guerin, onto the back, Rafalski, then across for Modano. One to one, oh, and it has to work. Without a stick, it's Kiprusoff now. Still to the half boards, Gomez fed it in front, kick back, Guerin, drive, and it's kicked aside. Taking it as Timmonen, 18 to go, tries to clear it, gets it back out to center. U.S. has to regroup, and they lose the puck. There it's Dash back in deep. Kachuk chasing it down with Jokinen. They bang on the boards and glass with six to go. And we get a signal of an icing, I think. Sure enough, clock frozen with four, and they'll probably want to reset that.
JR, you were trying to get across there that Mika Kiprusoff was without his stick for 30 seconds. And that is when Rafalski and Modano were playing pitch and catch, pitch and catch. And they didn't know. They never were able to get a shot off, or chose not to get a shot off, and never took advantage of Kiprusoff without his stick.
Well, I think the fans did a great job of trying to relay that message. They're all saying, shoot, shoot, shoot.
But they do that anyway all the time, so.
But the puck was bouncing, and Mike Modano couldn't get a control of it, and they lost a golden opportunity to put that puck in the net.
And this is going to have to be a bang-bang play here with 6.2 to go. The right-hander, Smolinski, in for the face-off, and Amadi in the shooting hole, and he gets it and shoots.
Kiprusoff hanging on to that, drew another whistle, 3.7 to go, still time.
Still time. But boy, with Kiprusoff in his zone, and the Finns playing so well, we should not be surprised if this game ends just the way it is, 2-1. Team USA knew what they were up against. This game could have gone either way. We knew it was going to be an evenly matched game, and the Team USA would be up against an incredible goalie and a great defense.
Smolinski to draw with Jokinen. Brad Lazarowicz getting them set. Smolinski win again. He's got Amonte behind him in the shooting hole. Off the draw, fed on by Timmonen, cleared back out by Koivu, and Team Finland has come from behind in the game. They pour off the bench to congratulate Mika Kiprusoff and themselves on a 2-1 victory over the United States.
Take a look at this scrum. That says it all about the cohesion, the pride, the togetherness of this Finnish team. This is what they are all about. This is how they win, and this is how they celebrate when they've won. What an effort by everybody, led by their courageous little captain, Saku Koivu.